तस्मै श्री गुरवे वंशा कल्पतरुभ्यस्य कृपा सिन्धु एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातर्या जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया सर्वोऽभिनेतु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुदुमां तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वयापि न इति विज्ञाय राधे भक्त्या विहीनाय अपराधलक्ष्ये चित्त्वाश्च कामादिकं कृपामयीं त्वं शरणं प्रपन्न वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं वृन्दे नमस्ते
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माय humble professions in the lotus feet of my Parma Rakhyatam Gurudev Nitya Leela Pravishtam Vishnu Bhav Shri Srimad Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj and my Shiksha Guru Om Vishnu Bhav Shri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. I have told so many times that due to the mercy and special order of my Shiksha Guru Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, I have come here really to help the disciples and also to see his glory wherever I go. You know that how in couple of years he established so many preaching centers all over the world. He translated and distributed millions of books. So many devotees. And he has shown the path of the real happiness. So, we are all debted to him. So much debted. The new devotees who are coming now even, they have come only to his mercy, by his books, by his hearing Hari Katha. So, all the honor, all the honor, everything what I am receiving from all, I am giving in the lotus feet of my Diksha Guru and Shiksha Guru. This credit goes in the lotus feet of them. I know that you know so much more better than me about Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. How miraculously did he establish preaching centers in the midst of oceans, in the peaks of highest mountains, in forest, in everywhere. So, only due to his mercy you are here. And in the last day, you know that how he requested me to go everywhere and to nourish their the plants which are now in lack of water, they are going to dry. And that is my coming here, my उद्देश्य
पर्पस
टू कम नॉट मेक एनी मनी टू डिसाइपल्स आई नो समटाइम्स डिसाइपल्स सो मेनी आर बर्डन अपॉन गुरु दे कैन टेक हिम टू हेल्प इफ ही इज सो कॉल्ड बट दे कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग हू आर सतगुरु So we must be careful for this. Today is very pure day, auspicious day, because of the Hero Bhav or Avir Bhav of Balde Vidya Bhushan. What? Disappearance or appearance day of Balde Vidya Bhushan. You don't know? Anyhow. Both are same purpose. We should know that. We want to love Krishna, Supreme Lord. But He loves us more. We love Him because He can give wealth, reputation and all these positions. Oh, good wife, children. Worldly position he can be. But he wants nothing. He wants that their suffering should be go away forever and they should come to me. And that is why he comes sometimes in this world to help devotees, to help all that they should come to me and they should be accepted and happy. What we neglect. Oh, some devotee I told, asked, you are here for 3 days, 4 days? No, no. In morning, tomorrow, we are going. Why? Oh, busyness. I told that if you are giving importance to business, but business will not give your importance. It can give a little pain, your old age. Nothing. He cannot help you to be happy. And when you go away from this world, and it is sure, then what wealth will do? You will have to give up this body, all money, all positions, everything. But we are very worried for business to make money. But money will not give you happiness. So, if you are giving importance of money, even listening Hari Katha and reading the books of Swamiji, not trying to achieve a real transcendental love. We don't want Krishna. We want love of Krishna. Otherwise, we will be like demons. They will be like demons. So, prem prayojan. Our object of this life, bhakti. And the object of our bhakti is to attain love. Like Sridham Sakha, Sudham Sakha, Madhumangal, Subhan. Like motherhood, Nandu Baba Yashoda, and like books, top. So, all the transcendental sadhus, Mahatma, like our Guru Parampara, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, Krishna, Ram. They can help themselves to help us. He sends so many, Narada, Brahma, Sukadeva Goswami, Vyasa, Naradji, Madhvendra Puribhava, Puribhava, Advaitacharya, Mahaprabhu, and all like Rupa Sanatana, Sad Goswami, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Narottam Thakur, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, and after that Prabhupada. And his disciple, my Guru Dev and Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami. Why? Out of pity. But we neglect them. We don't like their mercy. Never. If I will tell, oh, come on, I will give you Krishna. And Krishna Premi, you can come. You will be busy in your business. Once I told anywhere that when any Mahatma, Guru Varga, your devotee gives something that you should hear, then they will sleep. And when I will tell that, oh, a very beautiful lady wanted to marry a devotee, and she's very beautiful, more than any husband. And then all they can afford it. So don't sleep at the time of speaking. Try to take it like nectar. Now we will begin our classes. I cannot speak so much. Time to time, I will speak something. Now I'm feeling better, so Pan Maharaj will speak briefly on Srila Baldev Vidya Bhushan Prabhupada. Why we are debted to him? What he has done? Stand up and speak. I shall formally vote.
गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकावै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः वंशाकल्पद्रुवश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि श्री गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई ऑफर माय इनमेबल ऑब्सेंसेस अनटू लोटस फीट ऑफ माय स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर ओम विष्णुपाद परिब्राज विचार्य वर्ज त्रिदंडी स्वामी ओम विष्णुपाद अष्टभक्ति वेदांत श्लोक भवन गोस्वामी महाराज एंड ओम विष्णुपाद परिब्राज आचार्य वर्ज त्रिदंडी स्वामी श्रीमद भक्ति नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज सर इंटरनेशनली आई ऑफर माई धन्यवाद प्रणाम लोटस फीट ऑफ नित्यलाभृष्ण विष्णुपाद अष्टोत्तर भक्ति वेदांत श्लोक स्वामी महाराज एंड नित्यलाभृष्ण विष्णुपाद अष्टोत्तर श्लोक गौरगोविंद महाराज एंड ऑल सीनियर डिवोटीज एंड ऑल वैष्णव एंड वैष्णवीज टुडे इज वेरी ऑस्पिशियस डे दिस अपीयरेंस डे ऑफ आवर संप्रदाय संरक्षक द प्रोटेक्टर ऑफ आवर गौड़ी विष्णु संप्रदाय श्री बलदेव विद्याभूषण प्रभुज दिस अपीयरेंस डे very auspicious day. Gurudev kindly gave him order to discuss about his life history and his teaching. Why all Gaudiya Vaishnavas, they also jetted unto lotus feet of Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu. Srila Param Guru Maharaj Nityala Krishna Vishnupad Ashtotara Satasri Acharya Kesari Pad ओम विष्णु भक्ति वेदा ए भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज ही एस्टैब्लिश्ड गौड़ीय वेदांत समिति इन हिज वन लेक्चर ही एक्सप्लेन एक्चुअल आई एस्टैब्लिश्ड गौड़ीय वेदांत समिति ऑन द रेस्पेक्ट ऑफ बलदेव विद्याभूषण प्रभु आफ्टर जीव गोस्वामी पाद देन ऑल ओवर गौड़ीय Vaishnav's philosophy about contaminate with Sahajiya Sakhi Bhakti and just these things. And even that time, so many things in our Gauriya Sampradayas. But again, Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad, Narottam Das Thakur, Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad, he came and he re-established our Shuddha Bhakti Dhara, the line of pure devotional service. But one thing happened. When Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad was very old and he completely immersed of his sadhana and bhajan, antardasa and artha bachya dasa, and he was performing bhajan and sadhana in Vrindavan, that time in Jaipur, some Vaishnavas, they also led to King Joy Singh II, to that and believe to him that the Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya is actually not real line of Sampradayas. Because Shastra explained these things. Sri Brahma Rudra Sanaka Iti Khiti Pavana. Sampradaya Vina Mantrasti Vikhalamata Sri Brahma Rudra Sanaka Iti Khiti Pavana. Four Sampradayas. Sri Brahma Rudra and Sanak Sampradayas. The four Sampradayas, according to these four Sampradayas, if you receive this mantra and perform bhajan and sadhana, then you will achieve of your ultimate goal. But in Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya, actually they are not belong to in these four Sampradayas. What is their Sampradaya? Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradayas. So they also complain and lead to King King of Jaipur, second Jai Singh. And they also complained the Shastra does not support to worship Srimati Radhika, who is the consort of Krishna Chandra. Even Srimati Bhagavat and Vishnu Puran anywhere not mention the Srimati Radhika's name. If you can worship Krishna with Lakshmi Devi or Rukmini Satyabhama, because Krishna, he legally married to them. But Srimati Radhika, she did not marry to Krishna. Any Shastras had the proofs. So in this way they live. In another Gaudiya Parampara, they have no any Parampara. That is called the disciplic succession. In this way. But the King Jaipur, and also they have no Vedanta commentary, these things. Because we accept that the Acharyas and Sampradayas who has commentary on the Vedanta Sutra and Srimad Bhagavatam and also Bhagavad Gita. That is called the Bhasatrayi. But Gaudiya Sampradaya, they have no on the commentary of Vedanta Sutra and other things. So how possible we accept a Gaudiya Vedanta Sampradaya, a Gaudiya Sampradaya is the bona fide Sampradaya. But King, that time King Jaipur, he believes and he has so much love and affection and found faith in Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya. So that time he also called Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad, because that time Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad, he was very famous in that time. As like he was that time Sarvabhauma, but everybody respected him. But that time Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad, he was very old and he did not want to go to Jaipur and he did not want to leave Vrindavan. And that time he also sent his disciples. Actually, who is called the disciples? Some persons also they complain. The Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu, he is not the disciple of Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad. But Param Guru Maharaj Acharya Kesari, in his lecture and his lekhani and his writing, he also very nicely and explained this thing. Actual Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu, he is the real disciple of Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad. And he discussed in these things, this Pancharatrik Diksha and Bhagavatya Diksha. Actually, Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu, a little bit also explained, Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu, he was born in Orissa, nearby Chilka Hrad. And then he also learned all the Shastras. And then he went to Mysore, and he also learned some Vedanta and Shastra. And then he came back and he also met with in our line Gaudiya Sampradayas, Nityananda Prabhu's disciple Gauridas Pandit, disciple Hriday Chaitanya, Hriday Chaitanya disciple Samananda Prabhu's disciples, what is his name? Rasikananda disciple, then little girl, lady
Radha
Damodar. And the, so Baladeva Vidyabhasan Prabhu, he took Diksha from Radha Damodar. In this way, but some person they also complain, but yeah, how possible? But Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru is the same. Chaitanya Charitamrita Krishna Das Kaviraj explained, Diksha Guru ke janiyo tahara roop, Siksha Guru ke janiyo tahara swaroop. Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru, very nicely and briefly, because or many personal devil speaker, they will speak, I will not speak so much, but I'm coming quickly of my subject matter. So Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru, this thing, Param Guru Maharaj very nicely explained, what is called the Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru? What is the Pancharatrik Diksha and also Bhagavata Diksha? Actually, Bhagavata Diksha is the third, the complete Diksha in India. Once you receive the Bhagavata Diksha and he is bona fide, that things. Pancharatrik Vidhan Diksha, according to the rules and regulations of Narad Pancharatra, who received the mantra from Gurudev. This is all true. But Shastra also gives so much importance in Bhagavatiya Diksha. That means you should learn and take his mood from his heart. This is called Bhagavatiya Diksha. Bhagavatiya Diksha is very important things. So Vishwanath, so Baladeva Vidyabhasan Prabhu, he came in Vrindavan and he learned all the Shastras, Ved, Puran, Upanishad, and all our Gaudiya Tattva Siddhanta, Rasa Siddhanta, and Tattva Siddhanta, everything he learned from Vishwanath Chakravarti Pada. So that time, by the causeless mercy of Baladeva Vidyabhasan Prabhu, he went in Jaipur. That means Baladeva Vidyabhasan, Vishwanath Chakravarti Pada sent him in Jaipur in that debate. And that time Baladev, when they came in that the debate place, that time they asked about him, what is your sampradaya? That time Baladev Vidyabhasan Prabhu explained, actually our sampradaya's name, Sri Brahma Madhya Gaudiya Sampradaya. Then they claim, how possible Gaudiya Sampradaya is Brahma Madhya Gaudiya Sampradaya, or it belongs to Madhya Sampradaya. Then Baladev Prabhu very nicely explained in our Guru Parampara, which is written by Kavi Karnapur, Guru Parampara, Krishna Hite Chaturmukh. That means Lakshmipati Tirtha, he is the disciple in the line of Madhvacharya. And then Lakshmipati Tirtha, his disciple Madhavendra Puripad, Madhavendra Puripad, disciple Ishar Puripad. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then coming in this link, that means our Pancharatrik Diksha and Bhagavata Diksha also included in these things. So Vishwanath Chakravarti Pada, he established these things. Our Sampradaya is real bona fide Sampradaya. Sampradaya ke vichar, he also explained these things. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he accepted Madhya Sampradaya. Why? Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said there are many things in the Madhya Sampradaya. Madhvacharya, he explained the five difference. Ishwara Jive Bhed, Jade Jade Bhed, Jive Jade Bhed, Jive Jive Bhed, Ishwara Jive Bhed. Five difference. That the difference between the entities, difference between the inert jade, difference between the jade and jade, inert and inert. Jive Jive Bhed, difference between entities and entities. He explained these things. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that is called the completely discussed about the Daitavad. Suddha Daitavad. He explained these things. Because that time need Shankaracharya, he explained that is called the Adaitavad. So Madhvacharya, he also discuss this in Daitavad. In another thing, Madhvacharya in Sampradayas, also that the mood of Vrindavan, Gopis mood in India. And they worship Bal Gopal Krishna Chandra, very nice, beautiful, with charming the yogurt stick in his hand. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted also many regions. And then he established this thing, say Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya is the real Sampradayas. They are not other Sampradayas. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he did not manifested in another sampradaya. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he did not have the rules and regulations of the Shastra. Because he is Bhagavan. He preaches, apani achari karma jibere sikhan, apani na koi re dharma sikhan na jaye. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself practiced and also preached these things. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he did not to mention any new sampradayas. Now Vrindavan also many sampradayas they are making. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu didn't. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he accepted Brahma Sampradaya, Madhvacharya, these sampradayas. Then also coming to our another question, they also, the Shastra does not support worship to Sumati Radhika. She is the consort of Krishna Chandra. But Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu nicely explained this thing. Srimati Radhika, she is called the Hladini Shakti, Vishnu Shakti Parabhakta, Khetrakna Katha Tathapara, Abhidda Karma Sangana, Tritiya Shakti Issati. Parasakti, that is called the Hladini Shakti. Who is the Hladini Shakti? Srimati Radhika. Srimati Radhika, she is the embodiment of Hladini Shakti. Shakti, Shakti, Matur, Dayo, Abheto. There is no difference between potency and potent. So Srimati Radhika is the Hladini Shakti. Baladev Vidyabhushan established these things. And he also established, Shastra also explained, there is no difference between Narayana and Krishna. Siddhanta Tattva Vedesu Opi. Sri Krishna, Sarupa Yavastati. Rasanas Krishnate, Krishna Rupa, Evus Rasasthiti. According to Siddhanta, there are no difference between Narayana, Krishna, Ram, or Nishina. But according to Tattva Siddhanta, there are far difference. Krishna is called Rasika Sekhar Krishna Parama Karun. He is Rasik. He performs many types of Ras with his Shakti. So Baladev Vidyabhushan established this thing. Srimati Radhika, she is the original Shakti. All Shaktis, potencies actually manifested from Srimati Radhika. He established the first Shloka Srimad Bhagavatam. Janamadasya Jata Anayaditaradasya Vigyasya. This Shloka Janamadasya Janma Adi. Everything, all Shaktis manifested from Srimati Radhika. Srimati Radhika, she is the original. Even Lakshmi, Rukmini, Sakta, Bham, all the jar, they are the manifested from Srimati Radhika. So Baladev Vidyabhushan explained Srimati Radhika as him, and he gave quotation, all the Ved, Puran, Shastra in the. And he also established the Baladev, Srimati Radhika, she is the topmost. Manindra Vinda Vannite, this slogan also speaks. Many Shastras also read, all the demigods, even the Anantakoti Vishnu Loka Namra Parma Darchite, he gave the many slokas and he also explained, O Srimati Radhika, she did not marry with Krishna, Satyavad, because that the actual this debate in the Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya and another Sampradaya, that is called Ramanuja Sampradaya, who believes in Sakyavad, in doctrine of Sakyavad. They sold Lakshmi and Narayan, they married, Ram Sita married, but Radha and Krishna, they did not marry. But Baladev Vidyabhushan also explained, Krishna is a Rasik. How did he marry? This is very difficult things. Those who are Rasik Vaishnava, they can understand these things. Those who are arasik, arasakva kak to say gyan nimma phali, rasakva kokil, puse primamra mukuli. Those are ignorant person, they can understand these things. This is very confidential things. But if you are asking about Radha Krishna's marriage ceremony, he also quoted the verse from Radha Hridaya Brahmando Puran. Brahmaji, he also married the ceremony of Radha and Krishna in Bhandirvan. You know, this Leela in Bhandirvan, this Leela also performed. Gandharva, that is called the. And many times, many also Leelas in Gandharva Vibha, these things. So why not worship? If you think that this is not legal, but they also married these things. So Vishwanath Srila Baladev Vidyabhushan to explain this thing. And they also, another questions, oh, where is the name of Srimati Radhika in Srimad Bhagavatam? Baladev Vidyabhushan quoted, every sloka of Srimad Bhagavatam, Radha Nam. Every sloka. But he also quoted some Radha Siradhayat. श्रीमती राधा नाम इवन वेदांत सूत्र अल्सो राधा नाम इज देयर इवन ऋग्वेद अल्सो राधा माधव दैव माधवे नैव राधया वेद पुराण उपनिषद एवरीवेयर राधा नाम बलदेव विद्याभूषण एस्टैब्लिश दिस थिंग देन बट दे डिड नॉट एक्सेप्ट ओके वी एक्सेप्ट इफ यू हैव कमेंट्री ऑफ वेदांत सूत्र मध्वाचार्य रामानुजाचार्य निंबादित्य विष्णु स्वामी देर ऑल्सो रोट वेदांत सूत्र दे रोट द कमेंट्री ऑफ वेदांत हैव यू गौड़ीय संप्रदाय वेदांत सूत्र इफ यू हैव नो वेदांत सूत्र वी कैन नॉट एक्सेप्ट दैट टाइम बलदेव प्रभु रिक्वेस्टेड देम ओके यू गिव मी वन मंथ I will also
only
3 days.
Only 3 days. Okay. He has no time to stay there.
So Baladev, Baladev Vidya Bhadan, Bhadan Prabhu, Baladev Vidya Bhadan Prabhu, he also prayed to Lotus Feet of Govinda Dev. Okay. By the causeless mercy of Govinda Dev, Baladev Prabhu, Baladev Vidya Bhadan Prabhu, he also wrote Govinda Hasya. प्रभु Actually, all the credit of whose? Gurupad Khodna. That is called Vishwanath Chakravarti Pal. Now, his name is golden letter in our Gaudiya history.
Thank you.
So, Baladev Vidyabhushan, I also pray to Lotus, I also offer my Dhanavad Pranam, Lotus Feet of Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu, and Sampradayi, which are very nice, these things we heard in the Lotus Month of Gurudev. वंशाभि कृपा सिंधु विवच पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः
ज्ञानमतिभिरन्दस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलय तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमो नमः नमो विष्णुपराय राधिकाय प्रियात्मने नमः श्रीसिंहभक्तिभिरन्तनारायणाय नमस्ते गुरुदेवाय सर्वसिद्धिप्रदाय सर्वमङ्गलकाय सर्व आनन्दाय जय श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्रीअद्वैताधार हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
My associates and all.
So, Hare Krishna. First of all, I have to explain why I call Guru Maharaj here. It's a big question. Well, I'm not so learned, but I hear from Guru Maharaj, why Sadhu Sangha? Varum? Why it is important? And why Sadhu is coming from Vrindavan to Western country? They can stay here. What is necessary to coming here? But as we know from Sadhu Sangha, that Krishna is helping the binding soul who is crying outside of Vrindavan to want to be helped. So you can see my Guru Maharaj is Patita Pavan, and of course it's the mercy of his Guru Maharaj there. Because if I'm talking about my Guru Maharaj, this means I'm talking about his Guru Maharaj and his Guru Maharaj. So I'm not talking only about my Guru Maharaj, but following the principle of Guru Parampara. So Gurudev is coming to helping the souls who are crying here for the lightness. You can say we want to come out from the darkness. So our Guru Maharaj is giving us the chance to hearing the Harikatha and the Leela of Radha and Krishna. Through this Harikatha, Guru Maharaj is giving us the chance to associate with the name of Radha and Krishna, to him, to doing the service, to seva, not only to listening, but also doing some seva to Guru and Vaishnava, we can realize some things about Radha and Krishna. So Guru Maharaj is coming to the West. Why? He doesn't have to come, but he's doing for us because we need him here very, very badly. Because what we're doing, we say we're doing business and this and that. It's true. We're thinking without business we cannot survive. But the one who's doing sadhu sangha, they know Krishna is preparing everything through the sadhus. We cannot do anything. We think we are giving donation to Guru Maharaj, maybe 100,000, 200,000, but the knowledge, the mercy, what we're receiving through Gurudev, that we cannot pay in one word. There's a sloka, what is it? Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Sastra Kahe, Lava Matra Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Siddhi Hoy. So even a little bit of a Sadhu Sangha, we cannot pay in one birth life, maybe 1,000 birth life, we have to pay for that. So that mercy is coming through our Guru Parampara. And we are so fortunate that we are in this line of Mahaprabhu, where his love is streaming like the ocean. And from where? To our Guru Parampara. So we are very fortunate to be here on this moment to have a sadhu like my Guru Maharaj. I love him very much, and so do you all. And for me, is he like my father, my mother. And because he's taking me out of the darkness where I was living. Not only him, but all his disciples who is following him. From Madhu Maharaj to everybody here, all my Shiksha Guru, and you all, if you're following my Guru Maharaj, so you are all in my heart. So I will welcome you all here in Holland to have some Sadhu Sangha, and we hope to give that what my Guru Maharaj to give to you. So according to our Samiti, Sigaurivanta Samiti here in Holland, we welcome everybody here because he is the generator in our heart. If he's not here, we cannot come together. Maybe fighting outside on the street, we see Hari Bol is good. But because of our Guru Maharaj, we are here hand in hand and we are struggling to do some seva for everybody. So please forgive us if we're doing something mistake in the service and according to our ethic, Vaishnava ethic, I don't know anything. But because I follow my Guru Maharaj instruction, so I listen a little bit. So please forgive us. If there is some mistake in our seva. And Guru Maharaj, we're thanking you from our deep our heart, from on behalf of everybody, that you can give us the mercy. Hare Krishna. Thank you.
On this occasion, I'm remembering Sri Siddha Bhakti Gaur Govind Maharaj. He was very bold, this speaker. Never cared for anyone. Only he cared for Siddhant and Guru and Vaishnava. So I appreciate. Also, he was very near and dear to me. He used to read my books. And so many times he came to me. So he was preaching so well. That some of jealous his god brothers banned on him to come here in Australia, in Germany, France, or Indonesia,
America,
everywhere. He thought that, oh, I prefer to give my life than to be banned. He never cared for anyone. He told very boldly that Jivas has not come from Golok Vrindavan. They have not deviated from there. They are from marginal lines, those who are here. And those who are liberated and have gone after so many long time, after sadhan, how they can fall there? And it is told in Bhagavatam, Gita and everywhere. Jadgatva nani vartante tadham paramam. Anyone cannot go return from there. They can come to help their devotees in this world with Krishna or by the order of Krishna and Radha. And so many things. He was in real line of Rupanuga. So I remember everything. Especially he told his disciples, oh, go and take shelter of Srila Narayan Maharaj And that is, I am very happy that, oh, so many disciples everywhere, they came to me and they are with me. You know, Aranya Maharaj, Ashram Maharaj, Damodar Maharaj, yes, Bhakta Sarup, and here, all. Now I request Shyamrani Didi that some points see, Bhaktivedanta Bhan Maharaj couldn't explain thoroughly. So I doubt that audience have understand and not. I have some doubt. And if I will tell anyone what he spoke, it is very hard to tell them. They cannot. What he do. So in simple language, all the points you should touch and clarify what you wanted to tell. In easy language and hot touching language. But very brief, not more than 10 to 15 minutes.
Chaksur Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah. Srila Gurudev has ordered me to summarize in simple language the message given by Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Van Maharaj. My only credit in this connection is that I was born in America. Otherwise, he knows so much more than I do. So in simple English language, Baladev Bhusan Prabhu is the disciple of Srila Viswanath Chakravarti Thakur.
No. He is disciple of Radha.
I was going to say Damodar
Aradha.
Damodar. I was going to say in the Bhagavad Parampara.
First tell Dikshadu and then Shikshadu.
There are two lines of disciplic succession. One is the Diksha Parampara, and one is the Bhagavat or Shiksha Parampara. The Diksha Parampara is by initiation. And by initiation, Srila Baladev Vidyabhusan Prabhu is the Diksha disciple of Radha Damodar.
In the line of Shyamananda Prabhu.
In the line of Shyamananda Prabhu, coming from Gauridas Pandit, who is a personal associate.
Originally from Nityananda Prabhu and Mahaprabhu.
Personal associate of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu. His disciple is Hridaya Chaitanya. His disciple is Shyamananda Prabhu. His disciple is Rasikananda Prabhu. His disciple is Radha Damodar Prabhu. And his disciple is Baladev Vidyabhusan Prabhu. There's another line. That is the Shiksha Guru Parampara,
Bhagavat
Parampara. And this is the line of accepting the Guru.
More important than Diksha Parampara.
On the basis of accepting the Siddhanta of the Guru and also the moods or the heart of the Guru. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, our Srila Prabhupada wrote that Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur took initiation from Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, and he never did. So our Srila Prabhupada is showing that there's no difference between the Diksha Guru and the Shiksha Guru, and the Shiksha Guru, as Srila Gurudev said, may be even more important, especially if he has the same rasa as the disciple, and he's more advanced in that than the Diksha Guru. So Srila Baladev Vidyabhusan Prabhu is the Shiksha disciple of Srila Viswanath Chakravarti Thakur. And when Srila Viswanath Chakravarti Thakur was very old, he was living in Vrindavan. At that time, in Jaipur, there was a controversy over whether our Gaudiya Sampradaya is a bona fide Sampradaya. Our Sampradaya is coming from Krishna to Brahma to Narada to Vyas, Madhva, down the line to Lakshmipati Goswami, Madhavendra Puripad, Ishara Puripad, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and down through the six Goswamis, and down through gradually Srila Baladev Vidyabhusan also in the Bhagavat line from Srila Viswanath Chakravarti Thakur. So our Guru Parampara, our Gaudiya Sampradaya, was doubted to be a bona fide Sampradaya for the following reasons. A Sampradaya always has a commentary on Vedanta Sutra. Our Gaudiya Vedanta, Gaudiya Sampradaya, follows the natural commentator of Vedanta Sutra, that is, the person who wrote Vedanta Sutra, the same person, Srila Veda Vyasadeva, the literary incarnation of Krishna, wrote the natural commentary, natural because it's by the same author, natural commentary of Vedanta Sutra called Srimad Bhagavatam. But the pandits in Jaipur did not accept that. They wanted a more modern commentary. And they said our Sampradaya didn't have any. Their other objection to our Gaudiya Sampradaya is that they did not like to see Srimati Radhika on the left side of Krishna as the deity. They said, we accept the deities of Lakshmi Narayan or Rukmini Dwarkadish because they are lawfully wedded at as he was very old and he didn't want to leave Vrindavan to go to Jaipur. Moreover, he wanted to give credit to his disciple, Srila Baladev Vidyabhusan, and to show that he is real disciple by Bhagavat Parampara, or Shiksha Parampara. Maharaj was explaining that there's no difference between Diksha and Shiksha Guru. The Shiksha Guru is the manifestation of the transcendental nature and personality of Krishna, as stated in Chaitanya Charitamrita. And the Diksha Guru is the manifestation of the form of Krishna. They are not Krishna, but they are manifestations of his form and personality. As Krishna's form and personality are non-different, similarly, Shiksha Guru and Diksha Guru are non-different, and Shiksha disciple and Diksha disciple are non-different. So Srila Viswanath Chakravarti Thakur sent his bona fide disciple to represent him. Baladev Vidyabhusan Prabhu went to Jaipur, and regarding the fact that they said our Sampradaya has no commentary, he said, give me 3 days, and I will show that we have a commentary. So during those 3 days, he prayed to Govindadev, Krishna himself, and Krishna told him that I myself will dictate to you the commentary, the Gaudiya commentary on Vedanta Sutra. And you simply write, you simply be my scribe. So as Govinda dictated, so he wrote down. And this commentary or bhasya in Sanskrit, commentary is called bhasya. So this bhasya is called, he called it Govinda bhasya because it's written by Govinda. And then
the ultimate goal of that bhasya was to worship Supreme Lord Govinda with Radhika. That is why.
So to establish the fact that Radhika is the most bona fide person to stand there with Govinda as the supreme worshipable deity, Baladev Vidyabhusan Prabhu quoted many authoritative statements that Srimati Radhika is the supreme Shakti, Vishnu Shakti Parapropta. She is the supreme Shakti of Vishnu or Krishna. Vishnu and Krishna are non-different, although Krishna is the original Vishnu. From her come she has three functions, three vrittis, manifest as the Antaranga Shakti, that is the entire spiritual world of Sat, Chit, and Ananda, or Sandini, Samvit, and Hladini, of which Baladev, Krishna, and she, Radharani, respectively, are the presiding deities. Then she also manifests the Tatastha Shakti, the marginal energy, or the Jiva, the living entities, as Srila Gurudev glorified Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj for establishing that the Jiva never fell down from Goloka Vrindavan, but he came from that marginal line, Tatastha Shakti. So this Parashakti, or Parashakti, or Swarup Shakti, Srimati Radhika herself manifests the Antaranga Shakti, the spiritual world, the marginal Shakti, the living entity, and the Bahiranga Shakti, that is the material energy. And all energies come from this one supreme energy, Parashakti, who even Govinda Dev himself worships. Then he established, just as Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote in his song, Radha Bhajana Vina, anyone who doesn't worship Radha cannot get Krishna. There he says that all the demigoddesses, all the Lakshmis, all the queens of Krishna, the wife of Indra, the wife of Lord Shiva, they're all manifestations of the energies of Srimati Radhika. They're all her manifestation, her parts or parts of parts. So he established that Srimati Radhika is Krishna's Shakti. There's no question of being not married or not legally in union with him, because she is non-different from him. Krishna, Shakti, Shakti Matayor Aveda, the supreme reservoir of all energy, Krishna, and the supreme complete energy are non-different. As the sun and the sunlight are non-different, Krishna and Radha are non-different. Also, he established that for those who are so much adamant that they should be married, there's also the pastime that took place in Bandiravan, in Krishna's Leela, when Radha and Krishna were very little. In that pastime, they were just little children, but they became of teenage. And all of a sudden, there was a big marriage performed by the Sakis of Radhika, Lalita, Vishaka, and her other Sakis. And even Lord Brahma came at that time, and he performed the sacred marriage ceremony of Radha and Krishna. Although it was just a play for them, because Parakya is so much higher than wedded love for so many reasons, still for those who will accept Radha and Krishna only on the basis of marriage, Srila Baladev Pijabhusan Prabhu proved that they were also married by Lord Brahma. So he established the, or verified that Radhika is a perfect to be on Krishna's left side, and thus the pandits and everybody accepted by the mercy of Baladev Vijabhusan Prabhu, who got the mercy of Srila Viswanath Chakrabarti Thakur, established our Gaudiya Sampradaya as bona fide, and the most bona fide, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared in it, combined all other philosophies, all other sampradayas, and added his own Achinta Veda Veda Tattva, which is the complete essence of all the Vedas.
Thank you. Now, you have understood something? One thing? Oh, that is enough. Before this, I want to clarify one thing. That my, or perhaps, Guru Bhrata from Germany, your disciple of Siddha Prabhupada Bhakti, huh? Oh, he asked a question. The essence of that question was, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, has he second initiation or not? Because he has no secretary. How we can say that his second initiation was done and who gave him second initiation? So he was in dilemma. I think he's not so fortunate, or anyone not fortunate to be in a high class of associations. They must know. A true devotee should not be in any class of dilemma about bhakti. Especially Bhakti Vinod Thakur is Gadadhar. That is Srimati Radhika, manifestation of Radhika. He is Paramahansa, more than Paramahansa, Charamahansa. He knows everything. He was Guru. And he was also seventh Goswami, six others, and he was seventh. And you know, he gave mantra to Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. You know all these things. And Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Goswami, followed him totally. By one letter to another. He did not write and practice anything beyond Bhakti Vinod Thakur wanted. So we should know, and I want to clarify you all that what is called Diksha. I think that we translate Diksha word by second initiation or Brahman initiation, but it is wrong. Swamiji's made it easy to tell the Western devotees who have no conception of Diksha. And that is why he called that they should easily understand Diksha. But this is not the meaning of Diksha, truly. Second initiation. What do you mean by second initiation? What do you mean?